Hello there, my name is Alan. I'm here to talk to you about what's new with YouTube and IFT. Oh, and we're also back with another giveaway, so stay tuned to find out how you could win a free year of IFT Pro and a YouTube premium license by sharing your Applet ideas with us. The YouTube service on IFT was recently updated to include 4 new triggers and 4 new queries that I've been using to automate how I use YouTube. I'll talk you through a few of my favorite applets that I've made so far. I love watching Linus Tech Tips, and while I'm subscribed and get notifications, I find myself getting behind on what I'd like to watch. The new triggers from IFT allow me to plan a little bit. So now, I've put the new video by channel trigger to work, and I use Google Calendar to block off some time in the evening to watch Linus Tech Tips' latest video. So there are other public channels out there that amaze me. I wonder sometimes who they follow or who they're interested in. So I can use a new subscription trigger with YouTube to see who they're subscribing to. Just remember, the channel has to be a public one. Otherwise, you can't see their subscriptions. By the way, if you want a list of your own subscriptions, you just need to leave the field blank in the YouTube channel ID field. Either way, you can record it in your day one journal or a Google Doc for a review later. We use YouTube every day. We find our content on what we would like on anything from cooking, smart home tech, music, favorite shows, and everything in between. But do you know what one of the fantastic things about YouTube is that a lot of people don't really know about? YouTube has one of the most powerful search engines, second only to Google. What if you could actually harness this power with IFT? It leads me to the third trigger I want to talk to you about that saves me so much time. It's brand new, but it's already allowing me to get all my videos lined up with no effort for me. I created a weekly email digest so all those searches are happening in the background. Then I get the weekly email of all the searches that I've had for smart home automation to my Gmail account. It's that quick and easy. I call it the new smart home video search, and I get to see the fruits of IFT's labor every Saturday at noon. And this is what I do for my MBA highlights. I create the YouTube trigger new video from search, enter in MBA highlights in the YouTube search field, and then I add an action for putting the new videos and the title in a Google Doc or my day one journal. So now I have a way to document my research for things like school, work, or play. It's all in one place. Like if you wanted to make sure that you got your latest MBA highlights published at a particular time, you don't want to fill your Google document or drive with highlights outside a specific time range. It might be too much. What's amazing about this is that I can combine this new video from search trigger with one of the new queries that we have with YouTube. The query allows me to pick a video that is published at a certain time frame. It's called Search for Videos, and you can use it right now. Queries are relatively new on IFT. Queries allow us to customize our experience, and in this case, customize our experience with YouTube. YouTube has a few new queries, but here's two that I particularly like. Today, YouTube tells me everything I need to watch, and while they're right many of the times, I sometimes want to find my own new shows to watch, and I don't want to have to search for hours to do it. That's where the new list playlists or list playlist videos query can help me uncover content from creators I love. Using these queries, I can pull up playlists that contain a keyword or videos that contain a keyword. I can drop those results wherever I'd like and then review them later. But I'm finding it great for sourcing new content about topics that I'm learning about. Now, before I get to my favorite use case for all these new features, I want you to give me your ideas for how you'd use these new features. Bonus points for those who have created your own applet and also share that applet ID or URL. You're then entered into a giveaway for 2 IFT Pro and 2 YouTube Premium licenses for a year. I love listening to music from Spotify, so now I can find the latest YouTube videos of my favorite song. I save the YouTube URL for the saved track, and now I get a Google Doc or an entry in my journal about it, or both. Cool stuff. And it happens as soon as I press the heart button in Spotify. I just added the YouTube query, search for videos, and voila! I've added YouTube content to my saved Spotify tracks. By the way, we have a number of new triggers, queries, and actions from Spotify. Check them out in this video. Good luck and happy IFTTing.